What's going on, pals and gals? It's your boy, Senior Chris Beers. Another YouTube video today, guys. And I know it's been a minute, but we finally got to play Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War. Alright, guys, so today's video is just going to be a small, short commentary about my initial thoughts of Call of Duty Cold War, Black Ops Cold War, whatever you want to call it. It's going to be the latest Call of Duty coming out in November this year, so it's definitely exciting for me just because Modern Warfare was not my favorite game by any slightest of chance. That game was just not for me, even though I wasn't terrible at it, you know, I was still pretty good at it. Just wasn't for me. The spawns, the maps, everything was just bad about it. The only thing that saved it for me was Warzone, and I mean, Warzone's Warzone. But what I will say, guys, playing Cold War was a bit refreshing for me for Call of Duty, but it wasn't at the same time, just for the sheer fact that it's very disappointing and very heartbreaking to say that Call of Duty is going to start feeling alike or the same for a while. Now, my main reason for this statement is that they're trying to keep Warzone alive, and I understand it. You know, it's Activision. They're come on, it's Activision. They love money, and Warzone is bringing them a lot of money. And naturally, they wouldn't want to cancel that, so they're going to keep it going, and that's why Black Ops has to keep on running with the whole Warzone thing. The bad part about that is that means Treyarch, Infinity Ward, and possibly Sledgehammer, I don't know what's going on with them, but they're all going to have to be using practically the same engine that Modern Warfare used, just because Warzone was built with Modern Warfare. And that means a lot of the guns are going to start feeling the same, and the movement's going to start feeling the same. I noticed it when I was sliding around, and it kind of felt like Modern Warfare, I'm not going to lie. Don't get me wrong, Treyarch always adds their little twist into it, but eventually it's going to become not enough so that the Call of Duty can feel new. So that was my first problem with Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War. Second problem, and I should, you know, make it clear that I know this was an alpha. What we played was an alpha, which means it's, if you guys don't know what that means, it's an early build of the game, and it's not even a beta. So, you know, we'll see if a lot of the things we talk about get fixed for the beta. That's going to be coming out soon. But another thing that I really did not like is sometimes, well, not sometimes, I'm going to just flat out say, the guns feel like you're shooting an airsoft gun. And it's really surprising to me that to say that, because it's never felt like that for any of the Treyarch games, even the recent ones that I, you know, weren't my favorite, like Black Ops 4. At least the guns felt, you know, unique, and they felt like you were shooting a real gun. Black Ops Cold War, it feels like you're shooting an airsoft gun or a paintball gun, and it just feels weird. And I really hope if they like fine tune it. I don't know if that's even possible. But yeah, that's my second biggest concern. But honestly, one thing I will say, I was surprised by the maps. Originally, I was really worried that the maps they showed were going to be way too big, because the last thing we want in Call of Duty is a battlefield map. Surprisingly, the maps were really good. The maps were actually pretty, you know, decent sized. I didn't find myself running too long before finding an engagement. I will say some corners are a bit iffy, you know, some parts of the map, but I think overall the maps were all great. Miami was probably one of my favorites. The Moscow one was pretty good. I especially loved Hardpoint on it. And, you know, overall the maps were just really good, and I was surprised by that. So, you know, my initial reviews on the maps were just amazing. And those were like the three key things that I kind of saw when I first played the game, which were, you know, the gameplay, the way the gun feels, and, you know, the maps, because those are usually the things that are important. Now, one thing I will talk about is skill-based matchmaking. Everybody and their mothers seem to be talking about this on Twitter. Skill-based matchmaking is running the game and blah, yada, yada, yada. I personally have never really felt anything towards skill-based matchmaking. I think it's a thing that a multiplayer game needs, regardless if you're trying to play a ranked mode or a non-ranked mode. Now, I understand that some people are saying that, you know, connectivity should be priority number one when matchmaking. And, you know, to a degree, I don't know the code or the way Treyarch implements the matchmaking, but I'm assuming they do take that into account heavily. They're probably not going to match you with someone in the East Coast, regardless of skill, if you lived on the West Coast. So naturally, I think that the skill-based matchmaking wasn't even that bad in this game. Treyarch has, in my opinion, always done skill-based matchmaking. At least their tuning has always been pretty good. I've never really noticed it. And I mean, people are complaining that if they're good players like 2.0 KDs, like myself, they're complaining that they're playing against other 2.0 KDs, which I don't understand, because why do you want to play against? I mean, I understand why they want to play, because they want to look good, they want to get more stats. But you're trying to, you know, play Call of Duty. You're not, I don't know, it's funny, because sometimes these people, the same people that say skill-based matchmaking is bad, are the same people that say they're catering to the noobs. Yet they themselves want to be catered to so they could kill the noobs. So I don't understand it. I personally don't think I've ever had a problem with it. And yeah, that was the last big thing I wanted to talk about for my initial, you know, thoughts and review of Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War for the alpha version. Personally, I really enjoyed the time I had with it. Although, you know, the way the guns feel does concern me, just because I really hope that Call of Duty didn't start to feel the same. But the maps were exquisite, at least the maps they selected. I'm hoping all the other maps are this good. And overall, it was a pretty good experience. Of course, it was an alpha, so I am taking it with a grain of salt. I am hoping that the beta is much better and much polished, at least than the alpha. And then hopefully during release day, you know, the full game is way better than it is. But yeah, guys, those were my initial thoughts on Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War. Remember to leave a like, comment down below your thoughts if you were able to play the alpha, or if you weren't, you know, still tell me what you guys think about Call of Duty Cold War. And remember to subscribe for more Call of Duty news, Call of Duty gaming videos, comment through commentaries, anything Call of Duty. But yeah, remember, I'll see you guys in the next video.